I'm Sean Parks, and I'm a landscape ecologist with the Aldo Leopold Wilderness Research Institute.
And I'm Carol Miller, and I also work at the Aldo Leopold Wilderness Research Institute. I am a research ecologist.
Wilderness areas are extremely important when conducting research on climate change, and especially when we're looking at processes such as fire.
If we understand how climate drives fire frequency and fire severity today, we can then look at how we expect climate to change and try to look at how we expect fire regimes to change.
I've heard other scientists say that, you know, the tree species or the forests that we see today aren't necessarily reflective of our current climate. They're reflective of the climate of when those trees were seedlings. And so that's kind of the key concept here, that we need to better understand what are the climatic drivers of current seedling establishments.
We do sometimes go out into the field to collect data on fire effects and so forth, but wilderness is a little bit tricky to get into and to do field research because areas tend to be really remote and landscapes can be really rugged, and it's pretty difficult to get in there.
And so there's no way you can go in to every wilderness area and sample fire and sample climate. So we use basically, you know, data from satellites to inform our climate models.
The fire seasons are starting to change. We're getting fire seasons starting earlier in the year and extending longer. And in some places, that's happening more dramatically than in others. Longer season means that more things might happen. The longer a fire gets to burn, the more uncertainty there is in terms of managing it.
Some of our research has shown basically that the relationship between fire and climate is really strong inside wilderness areas. And outside of wilderness areas, that relationship isn't so strong. And that's a clear signal of the human influence and human activities that are going on outside of wilderness areas.
It's really important that we have places like wilderness where we can learn from and use as benchmarks for watching natural processes operate.